Hello, hello. Steve, Canadian Sasquatch, coming at you with a Thursday, Thursday Mead review once again. Yeah! Let's get it on. But before we start, I need your guys' questions. Mead Mondays are running dry. Shoot me questions down in the comments. In the description box down below, there is links to all my social medias if you wish to hit me up via a question that way instead. Also, in those links down there, there is the link to the CSB store where there are links to my Amazon affiliate links for the Meadology book. Please buy my book, please. Shirt, Meadology shirts, Make Mead Be Happy shirts. And a variety of other stuff to make your mead making experiences better. And with that, let's get into some mead. We are going back to Moonlight Meadery. We have ourselves Moonlight Meadery Fling. So this is a 14% ABV, and it is right smack dab between dry and sweet. It is a complex strawberry and rhubarb mead with orange blossom honey. I'm not a huge fan of rhubarb. I know rhubarb and strawberry is a classic flavor. My mom, my grandma, they all used to make strawberry rhubarb jams. I didn't like it. I don't like rhubarb. It's not going to stop me from trying this mead, though. So let's crack it open. And by crack it, I mean like do this little peely thing here. Take that thingy off. They like to use Zorks, which are fake corks. And I always say, it's not a good thing, it's not a bad thing. There's been studies done where corks are better for wines because they allow a little bit of breathability. Pop! But yeah, it's for, depending on how long you're going to have the beverage around for, a Zork or a cork, doesn't really matter. So here it is, just, it looks like a cork, but it's fake. Label out, and a pour. Alrighty, so we have a gorgeous, light, red, brown, ruby color going on. There is a slight, getting a little bit of brown to it with red meads and wines and whatnot. Oxidization can cause brownness, but I don't expect this to be oxidized or anything. That's just a FYI. And it usually doesn't affect the flavor, it just turns it funny colored. But yeah, it's, you get a little bit of orange down at the bottom, and it gets, as you get more amounts, it's redder and redder, and a nice ruby, light ruby red color happening. It's a very pretty mead. Especially like the orangey color down here. But enough looking at it. Let's get some aroma off the sucker. So I do get the orange blossom honey, and I do get the strawberry just right off the bat. I don't know if I'm picking up on the rhubarb. It has actually been a long time since I've smelt rhubarb. I just, no, I don't like the flavor of it. But I do pick up on the honey and I do pick up on the strawberry. So those two flavors smell really pleasant in the glass here. So with that, let's give it a taste. Cheers, my friends. Thank you for joining me on this thirsty Thursday. The rhubarb is in there. So I do get the strawberry. The strawberry is definitely in there. The orange blossom, I am tasting the orange blossom as it's hitting my palate. And the rhubarb, I don't even know how to explain rhubarb and what it tastes like. So there's a tart, sour flavor that is part of the rhubarb, and I'm not a huge fan of like really tart and sour for the most part. That being said, it does remind me of strawberry rhubarb jam that both my mom and my grandma would make. It is very well done. It's hard. It's... This is one of those things that it's like, I know it is very well done. It's just not to my palate. So it's hard for me to give good descriptors of. It's about a medium, full-bodied mouthfeel. The legs, it's got decent legs. It is 14%. It's not cloyingly sweet. It's not super dry, like I said, on the bottle there. Yeah, right there. It's right in the middle of dry and sweet. 14%, that 14%. Is super hidden. Like I said, I feel like I'm drinking strawberry rhubarb jam, which doesn't have any alcohol in it whatsoever. So if those flavors are your jam, then this could be a problem for you, because you'd down the whole bottle and be smashed pretty quick. But luckily, it's only a 375 ml bottle, so don't feel bad if you drink a whole bottle. I mean, a Coca-Cola can is only 355, so yeah. Same size as a Coca-Cola can. Or any soda can. Pepsi, Mountain Dew, Freshco. Freshco is my jam. So yeah, I do get the tartness and the sourness from the rhubarb. The strawberry comes through pleasantly. The orange blossom comes through pleasantly. But outside of that, very well done. Not to my palate. But I still give it a thumbs up. I won't drink any more of this, but I do encourage you guys to give this a try, because it is a very well done mead. the folks over at Moonlight Meadery, they know what they're doing. Try and get you guys, there we go. Moonlight Meadery Fling Complex Strawberry and Rhubarb Mead with Orange Blossom. Very well done. If you guys like this Thirsty Thursday Mead review, please give me a thumbs up for me. If you didn't like it, give me a thumbs down. But if you give me a thumbs down, let me know why you give me a thumbs down. That way I can turn your thumbs down into a thumbs up in the next video. If you haven't, I invite you guys to hit that subscribe button that's also right there beside the thumbs up or thumbs down. And while you're down there, there's a bell. You can ring the bell, become part of the notification squad. So when I do post a video, Mondays and Thursdays, you'll be notified as soon as they pop up. But Mondays and Thursdays, I'm telling you, Mondays and Thursdays, 8 a.m. Texas time. CSTCDT. I don't understand any of that nonsense. Either way, I'm rambling. We will see you guys later. Be sure to have a pint of awesome. I know I will. I'm going to swap this out for something else because not my jam. Yeah, I know. Bad puns. Cheers, everybody.